cool when a manufacturer resurrects an old nameplate with a new twist, and Volkswagen has been killing it. They took the old Transporter van, remember the one from the 60s that was super cool, and they made it into the ID. Buzz electric van. And now they've gone just a little bit further, turning that passenger van into a cargo van. Kitted out as if it were the support vehicle for Volkswagen's IDR electric race car, you know, the one that went up Pikes Peak International Hill Climb, the ID. Buzz cargo still sports the iconic V shape in the front, but those round headlights, those things are gone. In their place are LED headlights and a string of lights around the bottom that can communicate with pedestrians. Inside, you'll have plenty of floor space for larger race car parts, and those smaller parts can be organized in the built-in drawers. There's 230 volts worth of power, onboard air, there's a built-in vise. Heck, there's even a fire extinguisher, because as you know, safety third. The ID. Buzz cargo is powered by a 201 horsepower electric motor on the rear axle. There are two batteries available, so your range can be anywhere from 200 miles to 340 miles on a single charge. Now that is more than enough for this guy to follow that IDR race car up the 12.42 miles of Pikes Peak International Hill Climb. But come on, an electric van, I mean, electric cars are all over the place. It takes a little bit more to impress. And here's where the ID. Buzz cargo is special. With the ID pilot system, it can be fully autonomous. All the mirrors have been replaced with cameras, and there is a solar roof that can add 9.3 miles of range if you need it. Heck, there's even a tablet so you can watch the IDR race car buzz up Pikes Peak in a record-setting sub 8-minute run. So why even bother with the cargo van concept? Well, I have one word for you, Amazon Prime. You think those packages are gonna deliver themselves? We've got so many delivery vehicles out on the road today, and while the ID. Buzz cargo van won't do anything to alleviate traffic, at least it's not gonna be mucking up the air while it's sitting at a red light. While we'll see the start of the production electric ID vehicles in the States in 2020 with the ID. Cross, this guy back here probably won't make it to light until 2022. And even then, it will just be in Europe.